Now I will start the second part, the 100 dresses second, chapter 6. First I will tell you the summary of, detailed summary of this chapter. In chapter 6, students of room number 13 were roaming in the class, and then the monitor went to the principal office, and he had brought a letter for Miss Mason. Miss Mason read that letter many times, and then seeing the Miss Mason in the class, all students sat down to their seats. Miss Mason said this letter had been sent by the father of Wanda Petronsky. Now I will read this letter before the class. She read that letter, and in that letter it was written, "Dear teacher, my Wanda will not come to your school anymore. Jack also." Jack was the brother of Annie Frank. Jack of the brother of Wanda Petronsky. Now we move away to big city, and no Polak is to no one will call them Polak there, because plenty of the funny names are there. And they are going to leave the Bogin Heights, and they are going to leave the school, because some students used to make fun of her over their longer name. They used to call them Polak. And then Miss Mason was silent. She was unhappy. She took off his glasses. She rubbed it with the white handkerchief. Then she said to students of room number 13 that, "I know no one has done it knowingly. If anyone has done it unknowingly, it should not be repeated. It is a great matter of shame or embarrassment for the students of room number 13 to make fun of someone over his or her longer name." And then next class was the mathematics class. Mady could not concentrate her mind in her studies. When the school was over, then Peggy said, "We should go to Bogin Heights to meet Wanda Petronsky and to congratulate her for winning the dresses contest." Now both Peggy and Mady were going to Bogin Heights, but Peggy was thinking that she had done nothing wrong. Only she never called her Polak, and her questions used to give her ideas to make the new designs. And Mady was thinking that if she would be able to meet Wanda Petronsky, then she will assure her not to leave the Bogin Heights, not to leave the school, because if any students will make fun of her by calling her Polak or by asking funny question, then Peggy and Mady will fight for her. When they reached Bogin Heights, there was a house that was neat and clean, just like the blue dress of Wanda Petronsky. And Mady knocked at the door. There was no response. They came to the backyard. They knocked there also. There was no response. At last they came to know that family of the Wanda Petronsky had left the Bogin Heights. And then they returned disappointed. Mady had forgotten the matter of Wanda Petronsky. Peggy had forgotten the matter of Wanda Petronsky, but Mady could not forget. At night she could not sleep. Whenever she closed her eyes, the picture of Wanda Petronsky used to come before her eyes. She is standing in the schoolyard, and some students are making fun of her. Then Mady decided that she will oppose Peggy if Peggy will make fun of any students, any poor students, by asking funny question, whether her friendship may remain or may be broken. Next day, both Peggy and Mady were in the class. They decided to write a letter to Wanda Petronsky, and that was just a friendly letter, and they wanted to congratulate Wanda. They had written how she was feeling with the new class, how she was doing with the new students. At last, they congratulated Wanda for winning the contest. They were expecting they will get the answer soon, but the answer did not come. Peggy thought that Wanda was angry. That's why she did not reply dear letter. But Peggy had forgotten the matter of Wanda Petrowski. But Maddie used to shout at night in dreams, "I am coming, I will save you," like that. And it was Christmas evening, and from next day school was going to be closed. Miss Mason came in the class. She had a letter in her hands. She said that this letter came from the Wanda Petrowski, and she read that letter. In that letter, Wanda Petrowski has written that I miss Miss Mason very much. I remember the room number, students of room number 13 very much. I had new 100 designs, so I want the 100 designs which I had submitted to the school that should be distributed among the students. She made a special request that blue one should be given to Maddie and jungle green with red sash should be given to Peggy. Now Peggy and Maddie both came to home, and when the Peggy looked carefully at the face of the design, she found that it was not the face of any other girl, it was the face of Maddie. She became emotional and she went to the house of Peggy. When Peggy also looked carefully at the face over the jungle green dress, she found that it was the face of Peggy. Then they found that when they were making fun of Wanda Petrowski, she was making designs for them. It was the best Christmas present which Wanda had given both of them. This is the detailed summary of the chapter, and tomorrow I will give you line-wise explanation of the second part, the 100 Dresses, second chapter 6.